Suffering indigenous populations and the damnable zoological republic are set free. Chineke na nke pụrụ mmiri na chukwu okike abịa mgbanye na-efe wee na-aja aha nsọ ya mma mgbe niile. Onye ọ bụ naanị ya na-achị eluigwe na ụwa na-agba akaebe ịhụnanya gị na ebere gị amara gị na ọmịiko gị ebe ndị gị na-eze ebe dị ngọzi. Anyị wee na-eto gị agbanyeghị atụmatụ ọjọọ niile nke ndị iro. I wee nye anyị ndụ n'ala nke dị n'uwere n'ụbọchị nke taa. Anyị wee na-asị na ịja mma niile otu niile dịrị aha nsọ gị. Onye ọ bụ naanị aka ike niile na ọ gbadara aka ya. Anyị wee na-akpọku gị na-asị gị na nke ọma anyị ga-ekele gị nke ọjọọ ma anyị kelee gị. Anyị wee na-aja gị mma wee na-eto gị wee na-asọpụrụ gị n'isi ụmụ gị niile bụ ndị ikwu ndị wee zoo oku mgbe a kpọrọ ha ka ha wee chekwaa ala nsọ gị bụ Biafra onye m na Chineke na ihe ikpere anyị nkwa. N'omekataghị ka ndị iro wee were ala nsọ Biafra onye m na Chineke na nke bi n'igwe. Agbanyeghị atụmatụ ọjọọ niile nke ndị iro ma ndị na-agba mkpọ bụ ebe niile dị iche iche onye m na Chineke nna n'ihere bụ nke niile tụwa n'ụbọchị nke taa. Anyị wee na-eto gị wee na-asị onye nwe anyị na Chineke nna nke pụrụ m ihe niile. Onye ọ bụ naanị ya na-azọpụta. Onye ọ bụ naanị ya bụ okwu ya niile bụ ihe na amen. Anyị wee na-asị ezi ebube dị ngọzi na otuto na ịja mma na nsọpụrụ site n'ebighị ebi ma ruo n'ebighị ebi. Ise. Ise.
Welcome, my amazing viewers. Thank you so much for joining me on my program once again. I appreciate you wherever you're connecting from. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please kindly subscribe to my channel. Click the notification bell so that you're notified each time I upload a video. You will be among the first to receive it. Thank you so much. And remember, in this channel, we speak up for the people who have been oppressed in the contraption called Nigeria. We speak up for the Biafrans, for the Duduans, for the Middle Beltans, and for every indigenous tribe in the contraption called Nigeria. I am not preaching hate speech. I'm not talking down on anybody. I say leave and let's leave. And for those who have not said that we will not leave, just like the Fulani Janjaweed have said, they will not leave either. We are setting the record straight. I come online on daily basis to update the people and tell people exactly what the situation is without missing word, without being politically correct. We don't want the conventional media to continue to change the narrative. You know, I know that they will never tell us the story. The exact situation, they will never tell it to us. They always try to play it down and make us feel that it's all well. But I tell you, it is not well. All is not well in the contraption called Nigeria. A lot of things have gone wrong. A lot of problems. Is happening in that country of Nigeria. People are not getting it right. People are not feeling okay. It doesn't matter your religion. It doesn't matter your tribe. This is not about religion. Neither is it about tribe. Neither is it about your education. It's a matter of life and death. That is why we are crying out on a daily basis, letting the world know the true situation of that contraption called Nigeria. The reason why we are calling for the breakup of Nigeria is because that contraption called Nigeria is not doing anybody any good. Nothing good is going to come out of that contraption. It doesn't matter how much you try. Our Supreme Damazim Nnamdi Kanu, who was kidnapped from Kenya and sent to Nigeria through extraordinary rendition, and today he's in the hand of the DSS. He has not committed any crime. Mazim Nnamdi Kanu at one point in time was protesting for Nigeria in the United Kingdom. He was protesting openly, asking Nigeria to do the needful to protect the people in the north. Protect the people in the north, the Hausas and all the rest of Nigerians in the north. Mazim Nnamdi Kanu protested and called the attention of the authority to do that. He was protesting on behalf of their so-called One Nigeria. He did that and did that and told them that if they don't do anything, it will get to a stage when the insecurity will spread everywhere and cannot be able to be handled anymore. The Janjaweed ignored, maybe because it's somebody from Biafra that is talking. The fed is a child talking, he doesn't know what he's saying. But today, everything that Mazim Nnamdi Kanu have said and cried for on that very video when he was protesting for the Janjaweed is what is happening today. That's what is happening today. It is so sad that people who know the truth are afraid to speak up. you are afraid to speak up. If you speak, you die. If you don't speak, you will definitely die. So why don't you speak and die and leave a history for your own people? It doesn't matter how long you hold Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. He has made history. He is the only man standing, the only man who has spoken up for every indigenous person in that country called Nigeria. You can see in most of his battle, he wasn't only fighting for Biafrans. He wasn't only fighting for the Duduas. He wasn't only fighting for the Igbos. He wasn't only fighting for the Rudua. He was fighting for every single indigenous tribe in the country of Nigeria, in extension to the whole world and all black nation. Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is speaking up for justice. All he is asking for is justice. Justice and equal treatment for all. It is sad that most of the time when you see people come out, they begin to talk about equality in Nigeria. You see people tell you they are in support of one Nigeria, but they want a one Nigeria where everybody will be equal. You see them make this comment every now and again. Obasanjo will come and say that he wants one Nigeria where there will be equality. This one will come and say he wants one Nigeria where there will be equality. So many prominent men, even all those activists, they will come and say they want a Nigeria where there will be equality. Ask them, what is your plan to achieve that Nigeria where there is equality? Ask them, what is the plan? They have no plan in place. They have no plan. Even when a senator in Senate stood up and told them the problem with the contraption, how to make it work. A senator, an elderly man who has seen it all, told them that Nigeria can never ever prosper with the constitution they are using. Nigeria can never ever succeed with the constitution they are using. Nigeria can never ever be better. They cannot know security. They cannot know unity as long as they continue to use the constitution they are using. The man pointed at the exact situation and what is the problem. The reason why there is inequality in Nigeria is because of that constitution. Yet, when you ask these people who are telling you that they want a one Nigeria where everybody will be equal, they are supporting one Nigeria, a one Nigeria where everybody will be equal, ask them what is the plan they are making to get that kind of Nigeria. There's no plan whatsoever. No plan. Talk about the constitution. They cannot change the constitution, neither can they throw it away and write a constitution of the people. You dare not bring it to the table. When you bring it to the table, they will never listen to you. You talk about restructuring. They say they will never listen to restructuring because their constitution doesn't support restructuring. The constitution they are using, they prefer it the way it is. You ask for a referendum, they will tell you that referendum is not in their constitution. They're not going to listen to you. It is structured to favor them. They won't listen to you. Whatever you say, they will never agree with you. Even some things that are in the constitution, they will look for another loophole to be able to make sure it doesn't work. For a very long time, we see these people who are crying for one Nigeria, who say they believe in one Nigeria. They were all shouting for restructuring, restructuring, restructuring. Everybody was shouting. When we are saying that that restructuring was a distraction, people never believe it. Mazen Nnamdi Kanu remained in the path that he is, the path of disintegration, the path of self-determination. That was where Mazen Nnamdi Kanu remained. Mazen Nnamdi Kanu continued to ask for self-determination for the Biafrans, regardless of those who are talking about restructuring. Even when the governors called his attention on restructuring, he told them, go ahead and continue to discuss with the Janjawi. If you succeed in getting the restructuring, bring it, we'll see you on the table and see the kind of restructuring you have brought. If it is okay for us, we will drop the struggle for Biafra and follow your restructuring. But what did they do? Instead of going to do the needful, they turn around and begin to fight against Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. They went to the extent of trying to kill him, and Chukwu Okabiama saved him. Today, they are coming again. They are coming again. When you see them in their conventional media, the way they speak and the way they talk, you think they have something to offer. When it comes to theory, they will tell you how you can make Nigeria work. But the single thing you can do to change the whole situation, they will never admit to it. The single thing you can do, which is throwing away that constitution and get a new constitution that will involve every single region, they won't adhere to it. When you bring something meaningful that's going to bring peace, they will say no. Look at when the southern governors with all their sluggishness came out and begin to say they recognize what is causing the insecurity in the southern part of Nigeria, which is the movement of the herders, the killer herders moving with cows. They said they don't want open grazing in the southern part of Nigeria. Instead of the Janjawi to support this move, instead of Asorok to support this move, because it has been identified and everybody knows that that is the real problem, Asorok said no. Asorok insists on grazing route until they continue to walk and move through the grazing route. some of them will come out and ask you, where is the cow? Just like Tinubu. When somebody was killed, when a person was killed, a daughter to one of the senior members of Afenifere, when the daughter was killed, Tinubu went to that very place on condolence and he was asking, where is the cow? Tinubu was told that the people who kidnapped, who killed that woman was Fulanese. Tinubu was asking, where is the cow? Instead of owning up and finding solution to the problem, they are covering up, trying to cover up everything. Trying to cover up. When you talk about Fulani herdsmen, they will say it's not Fulani, they are not Fulani. And the most painful one is today, the media are always projecting that the people who are killing are not Fulanese. From what they are showing us, each time you see their conventional media showing kidnappers that are being captured, they are always people from the southern part of Nigeria. Have you noticed that? Have you noticed that the kidnappers that they show us on their conventional media are people from the southern part of Nigeria? They continue to do that. But when you come and interview the main people who have had face-to-face confrontation with the real bandits we are talking about, the kidnappers we are talking about in the northern part of Nigeria, people who have come face-to-face to them, the kidnappers, they have confessed, including people who have escaped, they have confessed that these people are Fulanese. That they are Fulanese. But yet, when you come to the confessional media, they begin to project it as those people are from the southern part of Nigeria. And yet, we are pretending that it's okay. It is not okay. It doesn't matter what you do. They have succeeded in going to Kenya, conniving with the Kenyan government to kidnap Osuna Mazinanikano, and they rendition him to Nigeria. And we are fighting and asking for the unconditional release of Mazinanikano, and some people are still fighting to make sure that he's not being released. Ask me, what crime has Mazinanikano committed? What crime has Mazinanikano, which law in this world, which court in this world have convicted Mazinanikano of any crime? Which one? Which court? As long as I know, there is no court on the planet Earth that have convicted Mazinanikano. None. But why are we the way we are? Why are we facing the problem we are facing? The most main reason why we are facing the challenges we are facing is that even those who call themselves Biafrans are not Biafrans. Even those who call themselves Biafrans are the ones setting the people back. Many people from the southern part of Nigeria are the reason why this so-called evil Nigeria is still standing. Go and check all the people who are issuing press statements against the struggle of the southern part of Nigeria, against the failure of and promoting the gender wheel are all from the southerners. Their spokesperson. The spokespersons who are sponsoring and protecting and defending the evil of the Janjaweed are all from the southern part of Nigeria. Why can't you resign? Why can't you resign and end this for yourself? Because everything you speak as a spokesperson, every video you make will judge you in time to come. Your unborn children will see it. If your generation will still remain. If there will still be somebody who is going to answer your name, they are going to see those videos you're making when you are protecting the Janjaweed against your own people. Against your own people. In the southern part of Nigeria, instead of the people southern standing up to fight for their life, it is a matter of life and death. It is not about Mazinanikano alone. It's not about the Biafrans. It is not just about the Oduduwa. It is not just about the Benubeta. It is about every single soul that is living in that planet, in that part of the world. Every single soul that is living in that contraption called Nigeria, it is about you. And this is a matter of life and death. So many people who thought it was a joke, today, they are not alive to tell the story. They were not alive. The person who is a victim today was a survivor to yesterday. The person who you see that is dead today, that is a victim, was a survivor yesterday. And tomorrow, some of us who are watching this video, who claim to be survivors, will be a victim tomorrow. That is how it is. Unless this contraption is breaking up and people will go their separate ways. That is why we are calling for the breakup. We are not calling for breakup because of hatred. That is not what we are calling. We are calling for breakup so that people can be able to manage their area and secure themselves. There is no way. It is very, very clear that the contraption called Nigeria cannot offer security to any single soul in that contraption called Nigeria. They can't offer any security. If that contraption called Nigeria can offer security, there will not be any attack in the hometown of the late Muhammadu Buhari. There cannot be any attack in the hometown of late Muhammadu Buhari. But as I speak to you, the hometown of late Muhammadu Buhari is under attack. Katsina State is under attack. Bandits are kidnapping on daily basis. Some people are still in the hand of the bandits as we speak. In the hometown of the so-called president, some people are still in captivity and they are capturing people there on daily basis, attack from all corners. This is where the chief of the commander-in-chief of the armed forces is from. The commander-in-chief of the armed forces of the Janjaweed called Nigeria. Their commander-in-chief in his own hometown, bandits are kidnapping. Terrorists are taking charge. Boko Haram are killing people. He can't protect them. If the commander-in-chief cannot be able to protect his own village and his own town, how do you think he will protect you? If the commander-in-chief cannot protect his own village, how do you think he can protect you? You see why we are calling for a breakup. We are calling for a breakup so that people can be able to protect themselves and manage themselves. Because the enemy we have are not joking. Already, it is very clear that they have taken over the northern part of Nigeria. It is not a mess. When we say it, people think it's a joke. It is not a joke. We are not just saying it. Even their media confirm it. The conventional media confirm it. That the north have been taken over. You were here when they told you that the terrorists in the north have united together and they are now fighting in one front. You were here when it happened. Recently, you saw the security guideline they were giving to Nigerians, people who call themselves Nigerians. In your own country, they are telling you not to go to some part, certain area. They are telling Nigerians, no matter whatever you want to do, no matter what, regardless what you want to do, do not go to the northwest and the northeast. A warning, security warning from the police that no Nigeria should go to the northwest and northeast. When they say northwest and northeast, you think it's a small area. You think it's a small area. That is a huge part of Nigeria handed over to the terrorists. And what are they doing to retrieve that place? Nothing. Nothing. We had, when we got information when they said Niger State, about 200 villages in Niger State are in the hand of Boko Haram. You saw it. It was on their media. The information came out. They suppressed the information. They suppressed it and begin to tell all manner of lies. Liar Mohammed come out and begin to defend and begin to talk several lies against the way to defend it that is a lie. But it is true. That is what is happening. The videos are there to confirm it. These are the reason why we are saying that you have to break this contraption up for you to have a meaningful place where people can survive. It's a matter of life and death. It's a matter of life and death. It is a matter of life. It is not just about Mazin Nnamdi-Kanu. Mazin Nnamdi-Kanu was the mouthpiece of the gods. Mazin Nnamdi-Kanu was sent by Chukwuka Abiamah to redeem every indigenous tribe in the country of Nigeria. But they didn't listen to him. They demonized him. He started for preaching from one Nigeria. They didn't listen to him. He went away to begin to protect his own people. They didn't listen to him. Even his own people were coming against him. Even Biafrans, we are fighting against Mazin Nnamdi-Kanu for preaching the gospel of peace, for telling them to defend themselves. So many of them who talked against him are not alive today to witness what has happened. But those of us who are alive can confirm that every single thing Mazin Nnamdi-Kanu have cried about and spoken about is what is happening today. What are you doing? You that is from southern part of Nigeria, what are you doing to make sure that your unborn children are safe? What are you doing? You that is from southern part of Nigeria, to make sure that you have that kind of country you are looking for. Those of you who call yourself one Nigerian, who is dreaming for a Nigeria where there will be quality, what plan are you making to have that Nigeria of equality? Already, you are preparing yourself for election 2023. Who is going to give you a Nigeria where there will be equality? Is it Tinubu? Is it Tinubu that will give you a Nigeria where everybody will be equal? Is it Rochas of Korosha that will give you a Nigeria where everybody will be equal? Name them. Who are those coming out to give you? Is it this evil man that is important that are going to give you a Nigeria where everybody will be equal and people will be treated equal? The earlier we wake up, the better for us. It is in our hand to get our freedom and speak in the language that the whole world will understand. The world are waiting for us. The world is waiting for us. The world is waiting for us to act so that they can be able to come in. If you are from the southern part of Nigeria, it is high time you wake up. The Biafrans are already fighting on different fronts. Biafrans are fighting on so many fronts. And you can see Biafrans are going on their Monday seat at home. on their own, airing their opinion, letting the world know that it is not well in Biafra land. And it has been activated in the whole southern part of Nigeria. It doesn't matter if you're Igbo or not Igbo. You can equally join on the seat at home to air your own opinion, to demand, at least demand for the unconditional release of Sunday Igbogbo. Join the Monday seat at home to demand for the unconditional release of Sunday Igbogbo. Sunday Igbogbo has not committed any crime. He has not committed any crime. You know it, I know it. Sunday Igbogbo that they are holding in Benin Republic, Sunday Igbogbo have won a case against the Janjaweed in a court in Nigeria. Sunday Igbogbo have won a case that he was awarded $20 billion for killing people in his house and for invading his house unnecessarily. Sunday Igbogbo won that case. What does that tell you? Sunday Igbogbo is innocent. Why are you not protesting for the unconditional release of Sunday Igbogbo wherever he is? Why are you not speaking? Why don't you join a seat at home on Monday to demand for the release of Sunday Igbogbo? It is not just Martin Nanikam. There are so many people who are in, even Showore. Showore is in captivity in Abuja. Showore cannot move out of Abuja. Showore cannot step out of Abuja. Why don't you join the seat at home to demand for all these inequalities and all this tyrannic attitude to stop? Since we cannot protest outside, if you come outside to protest, they will shoot you and kill you. That one is obvious. They will shoot and kill you and nobody will do anything. Why don't you join the civil disobedience that Biafrans have already activated? Join the civil disobedience in every part of southern part of Nigeria. Join the civil disobedience. Join it. It is going to go a long way to save the situation and to make you have that kind of country you are dreaming of. Sunday Igbogbo won a case in Oduduwa land against the so-called Nigerian. Okay, Sunday Igbogbo won a case. Ask me, why is it that the case of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu's invasion, the invasion of the home of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, which was more deadly, more people were killed, much more dangerous, much more evil than that of Sunday Igbogbo, up till now, the case has not been heard. Nobody has been convicted. And ask me, why is it that it is even now that people are talking about it? Mazen Nnamdi Kanu home was invaded. 28 people were killed on broad daylight. People were streaming the event openly. It is not a mere hearsay. It is not a propaganda. People were streaming it just like people were streaming the NSAS. Just like DJ Switch was streaming the NSAS when it was happening. You were seeing them. The same thing when they invaded the home of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. It was streamed live. It is not something you use a rocket science to begin to go and look for evidence. Why is it that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu has not gotten justice in that very invasion of his home? Sunday Igbogbo has gotten justice in Oduduwa land, but in Biafra land, to show you how devilish some of Biafra people are, to show you how devilish some people who call themselves Biafrans, who claim to be Biafrans, how devilish and how evil they are. Remember in one of the programs of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu told us how the lawyers in the southeastern part of Nigeria are frustrating the work of the IPOB, how the judges who are Igbos, judges who are Biafrans, who we are fighting for, are frustrating the release, the unconditional release of our people. This is what has been happening, and we all saw it, we all see it, and we are doing nothing about it. Biafrans in Biafra land, frustrating the release of members of IPOB who have been captured, who has not committed any offense. They didn't kidnap anybody, they didn't kill anybody. When they came to court, the lawyers go for their release. The judges will be frustrating the release. Judges who are also Biafrans. Look at the case of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, the invasion of the home of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. An Oduduwa judge have given justice to Sunday Igbogbo within a space of months. But Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, for years now, we have judges who are standing for the case of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. They cannot even give him justice. We are not begging for this. We are not telling you to lie. We are not telling you to use any propaganda. Justice from the law of Nigeria, from the law of Nigeria that you're supposed to protect, from that very law, give Mazen Nnamdi Kanu justice for the invasion and killing that happened in his house. Biafran judge cannot do that. That is how evil some Biafrans are. That is how evil some people who call themselves Biafra, how evil they are. Mazen Nnamdi Kanu could not get justice. In Biafra land, they are still postponing the case. They are still adjourning the case in Biafra land with Biafran judge in Biafra in court, court in Biafra land with a Biafran judge. They cannot give their own person justice. That is how devilish some Biafrans are. That is how evil some Biafrans are. But that cannot stop us. These are the seed that the Janjaweed have planted among us. But the time has come when we are going to weed those weeds. We are going to take away those weeds in Biafra land. It is time to take them away. Every weed in Biafra land will be weeded away. We'll weed them away. All those weeds that are growing with crops, all those weeds growing along with crops, it is high time to identify them and take them all out. And it will happen. It is going to happen in Biafra land. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu stands for justice. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, that was kidnapped and renditioned to Nigeria, has not committed any crime. He did not went to Kenya illegally. He traveled to Kenya with his British passport. He was stamped in and he was going about his business. He was kidnapped and renditioned to Nigeria. Kenya cannot deny that anymore. They have accepted it, admitted to that. Today, Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is being held incommunicado in the DSS. People who are supposed to fight for him are not fighting for him. They are going about their own business as if nothing is happening. The ordinary people who are sitting at home by their own self, sitting at home using civil disobedience to air their own opinion since they cannot protest outside, you are demonizing them, telling them how they are destroying the economy. Meanwhile, in that same you talking about the economy, in your presence, the government has sent out their dangerous weapons and devilish people to go and fight against your own people, to go and destroy what your people have built. And you are doing nothing. You said nothing. How long shall we continue to listen to these idiots? How long shall we continue to wait? We can't continue to wait forever. It is high time every Biafran stand up and speak up for what is right. We have to fight for our rights. It is time to fight for our rights. It doesn't matter what anybody is saying, whatever they are doing from any angle. It is high time you speak up. Speak up from your angle. If you see something, you say something. And anything you know you can do to make sure that Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is being released unconditionally, it is high time you start to do it. If you are doing something already, whatever you are doing, increase the speed, increase the tempo, increase it, increase it. Do not reduce it. This is not the time to reduce. This is not the time to be silent. This is not the time to look at your shoulder. It is time to look ahead on our freedom. The freedom of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is the freedom of Biafra. If you value the freedom of Biafra, you value the freedom of your unborn children, it is high time you continue to speak up and fight for the unconditional release of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, and he must be surely released. It doesn't matter what anybody is saying. It doesn't matter what anybody is saying. Whatever means you want to use to make Mazin Nnamdi Kanu released, those who believe on so-called, those who say they believe on their political solution, continue on your political solution and be haste about it. For us who are embarking on civil disobedience, we will continue to embark on civil disobedience until Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is being released unconditionally. And nothing on the planet Earth will make us stop. We can never stop. It doesn't matter what anybody says. It doesn't matter what anybody does. We are going to continue until Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is being released unconditionally. And he must be released. No matter what anybody wants to say. The freedom of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is not in the hands of human. It's in the hand of Chukwuka Abiyama. And if the people refuse to release Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, Chukwuka Abiyama will use even an enemy. Chukwuka Abiyama will use an enemy to release Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. If you refuse to protest, those traditional rulers in Igbo land, those people who call themselves elites, the leaders in Igbo land, the governors, if you refuse to protest and ask for the unconditional release of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, if you refuse to join the masses to protest, Chukwuka Abiyama is going to use even a stranger, an enemy, to release Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, because it is a mandate that must surely come to pass. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu must be released unconditionally, regardless of what anybody is saying. It doesn't matter the angle you are coming from. It doesn't matter the language you want to speak. It doesn't matter how you want to say it. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu must be released unconditionally. It is signed and sealed. Chukwuka Abiyama has spoken that. He has said that through the mouth of so many people. He has said it that you may hear. If you have not heard it before, hear it. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is coming out. Regardless what you do, regardless what you say, we are looking for Biafra. And the freedom of Biafra must surely come. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu told us that coming of Biafra will be the last miracle on earth. And that miracle is about to happen. It is going to happen. Biafra is here. It doesn't matter what they are saying or what they are doing. They are trying to delay the coming of Biafra. That is why they are holding Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. But they can't delay it. When Chukwuka Abiyama have said yes, who are you to say no? Who are you to say no? Who are you to say no? You can't stop the mandate of Chukwuka Abiyama. Whatever Chukwuekaema want to happen is what is going to happen. It doesn't matter what you say. It doesn't matter what you do. It doesn't matter what you believe in. It doesn't matter if you're fighting Mumbazi Nangana or you're fighting. It doesn't matter if you're trying to hinder the success of the struggle. Whatever you are doing, you are only risking your own life and endangering your own life. But for Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and Biafra, they will surely be free. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu will surely be free and Biafra will definitely come. It doesn't matter what you say, what you do. Whatever you are doing and whatever you are saying is inconsequential. It's inconsequential. It doesn't have any effect. Because Mazi Nnamdi Kanu will definitely be free. And the struggle that we are fighting, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is not fighting against ordinary people. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is not demonizing anybody. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is not just fighting for Biafrans, not just fighting for himself. He's not fighting for his selfish interest. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is fighting and speaking up for everybody. Speaking up for everybody as human. And for those of you who don't understand what I mean, I'm going to play the voice of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Maybe you understand better. Let us hear the word from our student leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu.
Fulani Janjaweed can overwhelm us is by dividing us. If you are an agent of Fulani Caliphate, if you have come to do the bidding of Fulani Janjaweed in our land, I am asking you this very evening to retrace your steps. Because again, starting from this very day, anywhere Biafrans are killed, any governor, any police commissioner who tolerates the massacre of innocent people will pay very dearly for it. We'll pay very, very dearly for it. Do not underestimate our resolve. Because this evening, first of all, I speak as a human being who is possessed of a compatriot spirit and empathy with the suffering of human beings everywhere, especially in the zoo that Britain created called Nigeria. Second, I speak as a witness to the suffering of Biafrans at the hands of their so-called fellow citizens in the zoo called Nigeria. And what we want to make abundantly clear is that we are warning everybody who is a stakeholder in the zoo about our determination and our resolve to ensure that our land is defended. This is a resolution we have reached, and it is cast in stone.
It is very clear, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is standing up for everybody, not just for the Biafrans. And Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, we never allow you to take the life of any Biafran anymore. It doesn't matter what you do. It doesn't matter what you say. You will kill us, we will kill you. At the end of the day, Biafra is here. We will celebrate in Biafra. May Chukwuekaema be my guide and protect everybody that is genuinely calling for the freedom of Biafra. May Chukwuekaema be my guide and protect everybody, every indigenous tribe in the contraption called Nigeria that is being under oppression. May Chukwuekaema be my guide and protect you. Every Biafran, wherever you are, Chukwuekaema will protect you. You will walk into Biafra alive and you will never lose your life. May Chukwuekaema God and protect Sunday Igbo. Protect Sunday Igbo wherever he is. Increase him. Give him knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, and secure him wherever he is. Very soon, he's going to come out and continue the struggle. May Chukwuekaema God and protect Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Give Mazi Nnamdi Kanu good health. Give him strength. Send doctors spiritually to guide and protect Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. No weapon formed or fashioned against Mazi Nnamdi Kanu in the DSS will prosper. No weapon formed of fashion against Mazi Nnamdi Kanu any place in the world will prosper. No weapon formed of fashion against Mazi Nnamdi Kanu by the enemies, by the saboteurs, by the insiders who are trying to keep him in prison. Their plan will never work. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu will continue to receive power from Chukwuekaema. He will continue to receive revelation from Chukwuekaema. And very soon, he will join us and we will all celebrate together. Thank you so much for watching wherever you are watching from. And remember us. Bye bye. See you again on the next video.
Thank you.